And we've got five red lights for the Monaco Grand Prix in LCR Season 10. And we are away, and the Mercedes of Davison gets a very, very good start already alongside of Melanie. Side by side into turn one, followed by the Ferrari. Davison not into the wall, having to give space, Melanie is. Very, very close to top four, up to the fourth corner of the track. No one on the steering wide into the wall. It seems Melanie keeping the lead to Davison, to Mulder, to Mays, to Ventham. Very, very clean start of the race there for a Monaco Grand Prix. Definitely not racing in open lobbies. Very slow into the hairpin. Melanie slowly making it some form of gap. Only small margins, but small margins are what make a good race. Davison trying to tuck into the slipstream to see if he can make anything happen on the first lap. Looking like it's not going to be very possible. Drivers are going to have to be very, very careful through that chicane today as not to get any warnings or penalties. Through to back now. Flat out all the way through. Left, right, right, left. So it's Williams that lead to Mercedes. And a big, big drift there from Melanie. Shows already how much they're pushing. We've got a car into the pits. It is Mulder. Mulder getting damage on lap one. And so is LCR F1 Ben. Both of them having to pit for damage, it seems. And with that, we've already got some pretty large gaps forming. It seems to be the top two of Melanie and Davison slowly making a pretty decently sized gap to Amaze. And then Amaze back is just all pretty close together. These two have been going at it all season, Melanie and Davison, and it's looking like it's going to be the same this time round. Because, I mean, automatically, they are literally miles ahead of the rest of the track, rest of the grid. I mean, obviously, this track is a lot about bravery. And bravery and instinct, and less studying racing lines and stuff like that. So, the Finn clearly showing where his skill is at, just like Kimi Raikkonen, being able to work his way through the tight streets of Monaco. That's exactly what I was talking about. The track limits around here are shocking, and Noam being the first victim to fall short of the Monaco track limits. Davison is keeping with Melanie here, not dropping off too far, not as much as Melanie's teammate is anyway. But other than that, we've got a bit of a battle, I guess you could say. The two Ferrari Academy cars of Ventham and Jarvinian. I think what we're seeing here is just how difficult it is to pass around Monaco, because obviously on the F1 games, I think it's about 15% of what dirty air is in real life, so it really isn't much. I mean, it's still there, it's just not that much, but even then, it is ridiculously difficult to even line up and overtake around here. It's just because of how big the cars are. We had smaller cars, and overtaking might actually be possible, as Mulder sets the fastest lap, trying to bring back what was a horrible first lap for the Dutchman. Rafiki is joined back to the session. Hopefully, can start catching up to Apex and Bourbon Boy and the like. On board with Davison, is he going to be able to look anywhere at Melanie? Probably not for a good couple of laps. It is going to come down to strategy this race. If you're doing a two-stop, you're not on the right strategy, is the best way I can put it. Because you're just going to get undercut. And the undercut is going to be very good around here, because you don't want to be sitting behind people. As soon as you've got that clean air, you can rock it off. You can be fine. But you don't really want to be sitting behind someone that's slowing you down. And I mean, we can sort of see everyone sort of dropped off from each other, as you can see in the mini-map on the bottom right. There's no drivers that are real close, as Davidson goes very wide into there, losing about 4 tenths, more than 4 tenths, it seems. Rafiki has had an issue, and a very big issue at that. Missing a part of his front left end plate. He's going to have to come round and get that replaced, I think. Ben gaining a position. Ben doesn't seem to have any wing damage. I wish it should let me see. Game. Please. Please. Game. No wing damage for Ben. Didn't think so. Mulder on the charge. And Davidson trying to catch up the time he lost by going deep. And I think that is Rafiki out. Yeah, Rafiki's out to back. Obviously, we're not going to see a safety car. It's a shame for Rafiki, but it means everyone else is scoring points today. Apex into the pits in the Aston Martin. Probably due to damage, let's be honest. It's Monaco. Feeling a lot like a traditional Monaco Grand Prix, just not really much happening, to say the least. The closest battle is probably Mulder and Bourbon Boy, which, I mean, we'll jump on board with. Mulder, I know, is a lot faster around here than what Bourbon Boy is, so we'll see if Mulder can make any sort of move up the field past Bourbon Boy. Big bra moment. Big bra moment for Rafiki. Mulder getting closer and closer to Bourbon Boy. Going to be looking for that move anytime soon. Gets the switch back maybe. No. Is going to probably use DRS to get past. DRS. Looks to the inside. Bourbon Boy not really contesting it. Lets the Ferrari man slip by. Well, he did just slip into the wall. Don't think there's any damage, but... it's to be seen. And then Mulder will be after Noam for sixth place. Or not, as Noam just lets both of them pie. So Mulder's next target is 5 seconds up the road of Jarvinian. Which is the next battle on track, to be fair. Jarvinian and Ventham. Is Jarvinian going to be able to make any sort of move shortly? Doesn't look like it. Jarvinian just not able to make the move on Ventham. No, and with another penalty. Getting caught out by the tricky track limits. And Mulder already caught 2 seconds. At this rate, he'll be catching the leaders. I think Noam's into the wall. Noam is very much into the wall. And has retired from the session. So Apex will be in ninth. Oh, what class act from the leader of LCR. We love him, really. He's brilliant. Mulder caught up another half a second in the first sector alone. Scrap that, a second in the first sector alone. He is absolutely hunting this battle of the Alfa Romeo and the Ferrari. I have never seen pace gain like this. It shows how much being in a battle around Monaco really slows you down. There's Mulder, who's been in clean air for the last lap and a half. These two haven't, and I mean, he's now on the back of him. He was five seconds back a lap ago. He's now on the back of him. He's going to be looking for a way past very, very quickly. And I don't think that Jarvinian and Ventham are going to have anything to say for it.
Mulder very slidey into turn one. Really wanting to get past, but these two are going to put up a bit of a bit more of a fight than Bourbonboy did, I believe. Mulder down the inside makes it work on those medium set of tyres, and he's now behind his teammate. Jarvinian had nothing there, understeered wide, left the door open for Mulder, and Mulder was passed. Now Mulder's going to be looking to get past his teammate. His teammate will probably give him the position, not to slow him down. He's looking to the inside, lets his teammate past. Mulder is up into fourth place. He's now going to be hunting down Amaze, who is on the soft set of tyres. Right, so we're saying, will Mulder have to make another pit stop? Or is he pit on lap one? Not too sure if he will be able to make it to the end. It is to be seen. He is currently 16 seconds off the lead, so I believe he will have actually overtaken the leaders if they pit. Just. Davinson not really catching. Apex with a 5 second penalty, Jarvinian into the pits. It's all getting very spaced out, as you would with a grid of nine. Well, nine still running, that is. Quarter of the way through this race. And that is Melanie into the pits in the Williams. Looking to undercut like he has every round so far. Where is he going to come out? Is Mulder going to be able to get past Melanie in the pits? There's Mulder. Where's Melanie going to be? He's going to be behind. Very, very behind. Look how far Melanie is behind Mulder. It's 2 seconds. I think that is 2.5, 3 seconds. Mulder with the undercut of Dreams is, well, best way to say it, innately leading this race. I think that's the only way you can put it. Whether his tyres are going to make it to the end, however, bearing in mind they are, well, already 11 laps old. It's to be seen. But I really don't know. Davidson on the medium, so he's looking to go to soft to the end, more than likely. Amazed will probably be coming in around still going. Mulder on 9 lap old mediums. Is that going to make it to the end? I do not think so. I'm going to have to be honest. I mean, it's possible it could. Because, I really don't know. I haven't raced around Monaco, so I couldn't really tell you if they would make it to the end. Bourbonboy is into the pits, onto the hards, looking to go to the end. Mulder looking to get past Amazed anytime soon, almost pushing him through the corners. Mulder looks to the inside now. Down the inside, is he going to be able to make it stick? Pushes Amazed onto the off the track. Amazed getting a penalty. Amazed not giving any room. Or desync, I guess. And Mulder getting the position. That was cheeky. That was cheeky from Mulder. But he was on the inside. He was fairly along the inside as well. So he was allowed to dictate the line of the car on the outside. So that is a completely legal move. As long as the car on the inside is alongside the car on the outside, they are allowed to dictate where the corner is. And, well, That's what Mulder did. Took the corner. So, completely fair move in my eyes. Although, all that battling is now going to cause Mulder to have to look back at Melanie. Melanie is caught up after that pit stop on them much, much fresher tyres. And I think Mulder might have to just give in to the Williams driver. Because that them new mediums are going to be a hell of a lot faster. Also, just to point it out, LCR F1 Ben is in fourth. Look at him go. Doing absolutely brilliantly around the streets of Monaco. Even though he did spin in qualifying. But doing brilliantly. David's in into the pits. Onto the set of hards. Clearly doesn't think a set of mediums will make it to the end. Is Melanie on the right strategy, do you think? It's to be seen. Ben is on the podium at the moment. Go on, lad. Melanie still looking to get past Mulder. And Bourbon Boy is looking to get past Apex on those fresher hards. Apex not going to give any inch though. We've seen him run that wide Aston Martin, but just can't be wide enough on the straights, and has to concede the position. Melanie now, still behind, still just sitting there. Is the best way I can put it. Out of the final corner now. Can Melanie get the power down to look for a move on Mulder? Looks to the inside, thinks better of it. Up through turn three, the sort of bendy straight that is the first straight at Monaco, into Casino Square now. Gaining. Mulder getting a brilliant exit of the corner though. Down into the hairpin, and Mays gets another penalty for exceeding track limits. Still very, very close between these two drivers, but Mulder driving what is a wide Ferrari. Very wide Ferrari. But it's not going to do anything because Melanie looks to the outside, thinks better of it. Mulder just defending that position with all his might. And that's going to change the order a little bit. BRL Davidson, 3 second penalty. Is he just, well, jeopardised his race? The championship leader gets a penalty for corner cutting. Well, that's going to shake it up. Up the hill now. Is it going to be the same as last lap? Or is Melanie going to be able to get a better exit? Off the corner, almost goes into the back of Mulder there. I think he's going to have to just wait and see what can happen out of onto the main straight. Looking to get as wide as possible to maximise your exit speed. Power down. Can Melanie make the move on LCR Mulder out of the tunnel now? Is he going to look to the inside? No, he doesn't. He thinks better of it. Out into the back now, and this is where nothing's really going to happen. Not going to see much movement through here. Onto the main straight now, has DRS. Is he going to look into turn one to the inside? Mulder just still has the straight line speed. More straight line speed than that Williams. I think Mulder believes that he can win this race. And, I mean, it could be possible. It's just going to involve Melanie crashing somehow. And I don't think that is going to be possible. Davidson looking to get past Ben. But Ben is just being a hindrance to them now. Obviously, Ben's going slower than the top two. Davidson, who is in an active fight with Melanie, but can't really do anything about getting past Ben. Apex has spun at the final corner. Probably gonna, yep, loss of wing, gonna have to pit for that one. Melanie's still not made the move. Is Davison gonna be able to make the move? Through the tunnel now. Is he gonna be able to emerge and make the move on Ben? No, he won't. That's a shame for him. Melanie and Mulder. The battle of the M's. Apex of the pits gets lapped. Sad to see. But it just seems to be lap after lap. Melanie, looks to the inside of turn one. And Mulder defends the outside. And that just seems to work. Work for Mulder. Which is an interesting strategy of defending, to say the least. But it's clearly working. So who am I to judge? But Melanie is a lot closer now, and Mulder looked a bit very, very squirrely out of the corner. Is he going to have to look to the inside, to the outside? Either way, no, he's not. Why do I shouldn't be hyping it up this much. It's Monaco. He's not going to get past until Mulder gets into the pits. Please prove me wrong. And that's a fact. Davison is past Ben. Don't know what happened at that hairpin, but Davison is past Ben. And Melanie is getting very close to the rear end of Mulder. Still no cigar though. It's now going to be a case of, is Davidson going to be able to close that gap to these two cars? I think he may. Obviously, all of them have completed one stop. Just Mulder is on much older tyres. But there is a car between them, being LCR Apex. Let's jump on board with Jarvinian Ventham, and as Ventham has been overtaken by Jarvinian, I'm assuming in the pit stops, as Jarvinian pit a lap earlier than Ventham. But there's not much to say about the grid today. It's a very small one. We haven't got six-time LCR World Champion LCR Leopard on the grid today. We've got one-time the FEC Champion LCR F1 Ben. We have one-time LCR Champion LCR Apex. We have the LCR Editor TMS Bentham. And I believe Melanie is an LCR rally winner, I believe. But he's not going to have to worry about the rally at the moment, as he's in the dry and thin streets of Monaco, driving an 1,000 horsepower Williams F1 car, trying to overtake the Ferrari of LCR Mulder. And it's seeming to be quite impossible, to say the least. As we've got a spin, it's Ventham in the Ferrari. Where is his front wing? Is it on the track? I cannot see. Game, give me another camera, please. He seems to be fine. Apex is in the wall. Was he put there by Davidson or? Not too sure. Right. Melanie and Mulder for what is round 7, 8, 9, 10, one of them. I think it's round 10. For round 10, into the chicane, Melanie, is he going to be able to make the overtake? Nope, sticks behind, thinks better of it. And as these two battle, it's going to get slowly, slowly closer for Davidson to make the overtake once Mulder makes his pit stop. So, it is going to be a case of... wait and see. Round 11 now, it seems, sorry. Still no difference. Still no difference. Ben's going to have to start looking backwards soon, as he's got a very, very fast Williams in his rear view, slowly catching him, of TMS Amazed on the medium runners. 11 laps, newer tyres. The possibility of overtaking? Probably quite slim. Let's be real. It is Monaco. But it just depends on if Ben can defend as well as I know he can. Which I'm sure it's possible. It's just going to be a waiting game of when Amazed catches up. Melanie into the tunnel again now for round 12 of Melanie versus Mulder. Still not gaining. I think they're just saving ERS, I'll be honest, but they're gonna have to start picking up the pace soon because Davidson is gaining. What a shot there. It just seems to be very quiet on the racetrack today. Very quiet in the commentary booth as well. I apologise for that. By myself today, which is a shame. I have no one to sort of bounce conversation off of. But I hope I am catering for everyone well. Round 13, I think this is now. Still not using ERS. I think he's just going to be sitting behind until, well, I can only assume as the inevitable pit stop of LCR Mulder. Is there a way that I can see through telemetry? Tyres? I don't think so. That's a shame. Ben getting a penalty now. Clearly feeling that pressure from Amazed, who is now a second off, less than a second off, going to be having DRS on Ben. Or not, it seems. But he is there now. He is there attacking Ben. Is this going to be a possible overtaking opportunity? Into the hairpin now, getting very, very close to the rear end of that Red Bull, and they even make contact there. sort of a love tap to Ben to say, get a move on. Trying to catch the cars ahead. Apex with a 3 second penalty for corner cutting at the chicane. Oh, Melanie seemed to be closing here. I think Melanie might be looking for a move now on Mulder. Melanie using ERS now. Melanie a bit fed up with sitting behind the Ferrari. Wants to get the move done. As now looking for every possible opportunity to make a move. And I think this might be where Melanie makes it. ERS is now on. Melanie looks for a move at the chicane. No, he still can't make it. I think Mulder has a lot of ERS saved. Mulder has a hell of a lot of ERS saved. If Melanie wants this, Melanie is going to have to outskill Mulder. Because there is no way that Mulder is losing any ERS. So let's just go through a quick run. We're going on to lap 27 now. A run through of the grid so far. Mulder by Melanie, BRL Davidson, LCR F1 Ben, followed by TMS Maze, Jarvinian, TMS Ventham, Bourbon Boy Apex, and two retirements of WR Noam and Rafiki. Melanie still looking for a move, but Mulder just has the ERS. Let's just check how much ERS he has quickly. 89%, 91% ERS. Mulder has more ERS. Maybe three times as much ERS as Melanie does. Melanie looking to the outside. Almost makes contact with the Ferrari. Just makes it work though. It's going to be a case of wait. Wait for next time around. Wait for the next opportunity. Because that Ferrari is going to be sliding a lot now. It's got to do 12 more laps on these set of tyres. It's already done 25. 26, sorry. By the end of the race, it would have done 38 laps on these mediums. To say that's possible is going to be a big ask, to say the least. But Possible maybe. Ben with another 3 second time penalty. Melanie getting the car turned in a lot better than Mulder is. Trying to look for that gap that forms on the exit of the hairpin. Getting what is not the best run into the tunnel. And is gonna have to just concede the position for this lap. So far, it's everyone on the grid has a penalty, apart from the top two drivers. Mentally looking to the inside once again. Still, Mulder defends very, very well. Amazed, clearly still unable to get past Ben. And Melanie getting closer and closer lap by lap. Once again, looks like it was a better run for Melanie this time around, but still no cigar, unable to get past. turn one again now. Looks a lot closer for Mulder, for Melanie, sorry. But still unable to get past. And I think it's the same for a Maze. Maze just can't find a way past the Red Bull of LCR F1 Ben, meaning that Ben could, maybe, on one lap fresher tyres, make it to the end. One lap fresher tyres than Mulder, that is, sorry. But it depends. It's, if Mulder can make it to the end, then Ben will definitely make it to the end and possibly get a P4 out of it. However, if Mulder cannot make it to the end, we are going to be having issues, to say the least. As Apex pits for softs, going to be looking for that fastest lap of the race. If that's going to be possible, it's going to be to be seen. But he's got 9 laps to do it, so I reckon it will be possible for the Brit. On to the start-finish straight now. Melanie is a lot closer than he normally is every other lap. Is he looking to the inside? Yes, Mulder into the wall. Puts Melanie into the wall. I'm glad I caught, just jumped on board with that. So Mulder, what happened there was Mulder understeered wide, more oversteered into the corner, more like. Corrected it into the wall. Bounced off of the wall into Melanie's front wing, putting Melanie into the wall. It's going to unsettle both the cars and probably going to end up with some form of damage for either one of them. Just see on the way past, does Mulder have any damage? It doesn't look like it. Maybe both cars are fine. But Melanie looks to be swerving in disapproval there. So the Finnish driver clearly not happy with the Dutchman. And with that, Davidson has caught up 5 seconds in the last couple of laps. A lot closer is the Brazilian. If the Brazilian can catch up within the final couple of laps, it is to be seen. We've got 7 laps to go here in this Monaco Grand Prix, round 4 of LCR Season 10. Although I think if Mulder has made it this far on these mediums, I think 7 laps is going to be nothing. I could be wrong. But they could, it could be very, very close for Mulder. But he is getting everything he possibly can out of that Ferrari. The Williams and Melanie now, it seems to be unsettled a little bit. I think he might actually be carrying some form of damage because he's dropping a little bit of time here and there to Mulder. That gap that was 8 tenths is now 1.3 seconds. So, unsettled or just damage? Hard to say. Davidson though. Davidson has caught a lot to Melanie. So if Melanie doesn't catch up soon enough, Melanie's going to have to stop looking in front of him at P1 and start looking up behind at P3. It's going to be quite easy, I feel, to defend around here, but, I mean, he's got a perfect view of defending from Mulder for the last, what's that, 20 laps? He's got a brilliant view of what defending is, so if he just does what Mulder's been doing, Davidson will be stuck in third. If, of course. It's starting to reel in a little bit more time, but not as much time as BRL Davidson is reeling in. I think that was a lock-up for Melanie. Possibly. There was some smoke on the apex. Davison getting closer and closer. That gap that was 5 seconds, that a couple of laps ago was 11 seconds, is now 1.6 to the Finnish driver of Melanie in the Williams. Clearly those tyres are going off, and it's where the hard tyre compound is what is coming into play now. Unfortunately, Bourbon boy can't make any gains out of it, seeing as he is 30 seconds behind Ventham. Although, Davidson could. Davidson definitely could, as he's now within DRS range of Melanie. These crucial five laps right at the end are where Davidson is going to start making the moves on the competition in second and third. But he needs to be careful because he's only got about 35% of ERS left, which, granted, is many, many more percents than what Melanie has left. And as you can see, Davidson clearly has a superior grip, as he almost has to back out of the corner due to how close he got to Melanie. But I think that Davidson may have this overtake in the bag here. Coming through the tunnel, down into the chicane, Melanie really locking up there. But you've got to remember, Davidson still has a penalty. I can just quickly check how many penalties Davidson has. It is one penalty and one warning. So Davidson needs to be careful that he doesn't get another penalty. But technically, if Melanie loses the position, he's got 3 seconds. 3 second buffer to keep ahead of Davidson. And it works the other way around. Davidson needs to get 3 seconds ahead of both of these cars if he wants any chance of winning this race. At the rate he's been catching, it is possible. But he needs to get past Melanie, and Melanie is not going to let it happen. Not very easily, anyway. Into the hairpin now. Davidson looking for any sort of way to get past the Williams and the Ferrari. Never have we seen a race finish so close here this season. Up into the chicane now. Still not close enough to make a move. And here we're seeing that train that forms of just not being able to make an overtake. We saw it in this year's Monaco Grand Prix, and it caused Hamilton to be 8th, I think it was. So it's a case now of can Melanie get the traction out of the corner and keep Davidson at bay into turn one. Melanie defending the inside. Davidson getting very, very close to the rear end of Melanie, riding that inside curb. And then it's a short blast up to turn four. Davidson looking to find some space to get around Melanie. Mulder's tyres must be going off now. Davidson going down the inside, forcing his way up the inside of Melanie. Melanie just leaving the space, and Melanie conceding the position to the Mercedes driver. The Mercedes driver has 2.5 laps to get past the Ferrari of LCR Mulder and pull a 3 second gap to win this race. And he looks like he's got the gap now, making contact in the tunnel. Mulder probably not really seeing him on the inside there. And now it's just the defending game. Melanie is just see if he can keep with the drivers ahead. Davidson needs to get past now. If he doesn't make it past now, Mulder, he will just fall into Mulder's trap. And Mulder's hit the wall. No wing damage, it seems. But he will fall into Mulder's trap if he doesn't get past. And he's got DRS. He's got ERS. Looks to the outside. Mulder defends very, very nicely. Mulder hits the wall, though, and Davidson gets up the inside. That's going to have probably have to be looked at, because it looked like there was contact between them, which is what pushed Mulder wide. I'm not too sure, though. But I think this might be Davidson's race now. Davidson just needs to pull out 3 seconds of time, and I don't think he's gotten another penalty since then. So, no, it's just 3 seconds gap, and Mulder and Melanie now making contact. Now fighting for that second place. They've already lost 1.5 seconds to BRL Davidson. I think this might be Davidson's race. Davidson, who at one point was 15 seconds behind on them hards, has come back after the two medium runners up front have, well, their tyres have gone off, and well, the hard tyre was clearly the best tyre to jump on that early on. All the credit to Mulder though, who has taken his tyres 37 laps. 37 laps on a set of mediums. That is unreal. It's still possible though for Mulder to win this race, as he's only 2.2 seconds off. If Mulder can keep 0.7 seconds to Davidson in the final sector, which seems to be Mulder's best sector, it could be possible. It's going to be very close at the end. 2.6 at the moment. Into the chicane. On the final lap of this race, Davidson not getting a penalty. Mulder not getting a penalty. Trying to get as much traction as he can at 3/10 separate the top two drivers now. 2/10 now. Davidson making a mistake right at the end there. He's probably going to have lost a lot of time. And not only lost a lot of time, but lost the win that he has fought so hard to get. Davidson comes around the final corner in LCR Season 10, Round 4, to take the chequered flag in first place. But not going to take it. LCR Mulder, after last race, trying to win his home race, wins here today on 38 lap hold mediums. The Ferraris are on top once again. Melanie second. Davidson, after whatever that final sector was, could have had the win, but gave it up in a way.